Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
We'll talk about acute lung injury. It's a separate sub-chapter and it is also a very important subject all of you should know. Acute lung injury. So what is acute lung injury? So all of you know that acute lung injury, if you see the definition, it is a non-cardiogenic type of edema. Pulmonary edema of non-cardiac origin or cardiogenic, non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema. The patient usually presents with acute onset of symptoms. That means developing breathlessness, tachycardia, hypoxemia in a short duration of time, mainly because of severe lung injury. So all those things they are categorized as acute lung injury. Radiologically, all these types are characterized by pulmonary infiltrate. Radiologically, you will have a lot of pulmonary infiltrate which are diffuse in nature, and most commonly they are bilateral. It includes large part of the lung. Pulmonary infiltrates which are diffuse and bilateral radiologically. Clinically, they have a sudden onset of acute respiratory distress, acute mainly because of lung injury. Okay, and here, if you see, the more important word all of you should remember is in the absence of cardiac failure. In the absence of cardiac failure. Absence of cardiac failure. Most commonly, cardiac function and activity will be normal, hence, it is called as non-cardiogenic type of edema. Okay. In acute lung injury, three important terminologies all of you should remember. What are those terminologies? You have, first thing is pulmonary edema. We studied about pulmonary edema in detail in the last class. The second important category is ARDS. All of you should remember this word, ARDS. Acute respiratory distress syndrome. Okay, it is a syndromic presentation. It is a syndromic presentation. Very important. Okay, third one is acute interstitial pneumonia. I repeat, in acute lung injury, where the patients present with sudden onset of respiratory distress, we have three main categories. Pulmonary edema, that we already spoke in the last class. Second, ARDS and acute interstitial pneumonia, that we are going to see these two subtypes in today's lecture. First one is ARDS. ARDS. Full form is acute, again acute, respiratory involving the lungs, distress, patient usually present with severe distress, and it is a syndromic manifestation. Not only the one organ, you have multiple organs are involved, hence we call it as acute respiratory distress syndrome. It is a clinical terminology. All of you should remember, if somebody says ARDS, it is not the pathological diagnosis, it is the clinical diagnosis, a clinical entity. Clinical entity. What is the pathological entity correspond to ARDS? That I am going to talk to you later. If you see the definition of ARDS, what conditions we call it as ARDS? The definition has been mentioned there. It is a sudden, that means acute, progressive, gradually increasing form of respiratory failure. Sudden, it is progressive form of respiratory failure. Why? Mainly because of severe lung damage. Severe lung damage where it occurs at the level of capillaries and alveolar membrane. Sudden severe lung damage occurring at the capillary and alveolar membrane causing severe distress. We call it as ultimately severe distress, ultimately leading to severe hypoxemia, sudden decrease in arterial oxygen saturations, and radiologically they are characterized by diffuse, as I mentioned previously, diffuse pulmonary infiltrates. All these we together we call it as acute respiratory distress syndrome, right? So what is the pathology involved in this? What happens? I'll just briefly mention in a picture schematic diagram. If you see, this is the alveoli, all of you know, and here you have a capillary in the interstitium, right? The main pathology, all the entities of acute lung injury, is severe damage to the alveolar epithelium. There is severe damage to the alveolar epithelium, one component. There is severe damage to the capillaries, alveolar damage, capillary damage, ultimately resulting in infiltration of inflammatory cells and plasma fluid, plasma in the alveolar membrane. All those entities will cause a similar kind of a pathophysiological mechanisms. Hence, they all club together as acute lung injury. This is the common mechanisms. Okay. What happens when there is severe cell injury? These cells will undergo death. And ultimately forms a thin membranous lining in the alveolar lumen, inside the alveolar lumen. This we call it as hyaline membrane. How this membrane forms, I will be showing you in the next pictures. Hence, the common pathophysiology for the pathologist is any case of acute lung injury. For example, we are talking about acute respiratory distress syndrome is severe damage, severe diffuse damage to the alveolar lining epithelium. Hence, pathological terminology for ARDS is diffuse alveolar damage. We call it as DAD, nothing but diffuse alveolar damage. These two important terminologies all of you should remember. ARDS is a clinical terminology, and diffuse alveolar damage is a histopathological terminology. Okay. After saying this, let's see what all conditions can cause ARDS. There are n number of conditions which causes severe diffuse lung injury. Few of them, it's been mentioned, I enlisted there, and some important etiological factors all of you should remember. What are any kind of a diffuse lung infections? Either it can be bacterial, fungal, especially viral infections. All of you see coronavirus, what are influenza virus, when there is a pandemic infection, patient will have diffuse lung damage. Some people will die mainly because of acute respiratory distress syndrome. So, any kind of a diffuse lung infections can lead to ARDS, right? And in India, one more important thing, biliary tuberculosis can also cause ARDS infections. Second, gastric aspiration, that is any condition where there is esophageal dysmotility or comatose patients, when you inhale gastric content, acidic contents suddenly into the lung, because it contains acid, it can destroy the major part of the lung. Okay, this can also leads to diffuse alveolar damage. Finally, clinically the patient will present with respiratory distress syndrome. Any kind of an injury, physical injury, for example, most commonly severe road traffic accidents, when the patient have multiple contusions or injury of the ribs, they may die because of ARDS. So this is most important thing all of you should remember. Then any kind of a fractures, multiple fractures. You might have seen any road traffic accident, if the patient has multiple fractures, they will be taken to the hospitals immediately. Patient will die because of respiratory distress. Why? Mainly because of fat embolism. So, any severe form of embolic episodes can lead to ARDS. Okay? And radiation. Ionizing radiation. This, all those things you will observe when you have a postings in the radiology or nuclear medicine where they treat the cancers. So, when they are, especially chest radiation, they will cover the normal part and the only affected things, they will give the ionizing radiation in case of cancers. Why? Because the normal radiation can also cause damage in the lung leading to acute respiratory distress syndrome. Patient may land up in severe ARDS and he may die. Not because of the primary disease, because of ionizing radiations. So, they will titrate the dose, they will protect the normal parts. This you should remember. Then, any kind of severe oxygen toxicity. Again, when you have a ward posted, you should see, before giving the oxygen to the patient, they will titrate the oxygen and then slowly they will infuse oxygen. Basically. If you give a lot of concentrated oxygen, although it has got beneficial effect, it has got more of damaging effect. It can also lead to lung damage, severe lung damage leading to ARDS. Any kind of drug abuse which is becoming more and more nowadays, can also lead to ARDS. Then, blood transfusions. Multiple blood transfusions. Any disseminated intravascular coagulation, DIC patients, because of multiple thromboembolism, all can cause acute lung injury, that is ARDS. In any patient who is having severe sepsis, they also more prone to develop ARDS. And few rare important thing is acute pancreatitis, uremia, etc. that you can see in the last columns. So, these are the things all of you should remember. So, when you have a ward posting, if you are seeing a patient admitted in a hospital for some other reason, but suddenly, if it is a septic patient or any road traffic accident patient, if he suddenly develops respiratory distress, think of ARDS. So, these are the normal causes of ARDS. Can you see the schematic diagram there? I'll just mention here what actually happens in ARDS. This is a lung alveoli. All of you know the alveoli are lined by type 1 alveolocytes. Suddenly, one big cells, cuboidal cells, this is type 2 alveolocytes. Right? Type 1, type 2, type 1, type 2, type 1, type 2. Okay? Here there is respiratory bronchiole lined by cuboidal epithelium. Again, down in the interstitium, you have capillaries. Whatever may be the inciting agent, whether it is a chemical, whether it is an organism, whether it is an emboli, whatever, it causes suddenly damage of type 1 cells, right? Because type 1 alveolar epithelial cells are more fragile. These are the first cells which undergo death. So, when there is cell death here, because of any kind of an injury, cell death, okay, it elicits an inflammatory reaction. Elicits an inflammatory reaction. And what will happen? The most important inflammatory reactions are IL-8, TNF-alpha, and we'll keep it as nuclear factor kappa beta. This is the most important thing which mediates the inflammatory damage. So when there is alteration, so in this ultimately leads to presence of or recruitment of more of chemotactic cells, inflammatory cells into the alveolar lumen. Okay, alveolar lumen. When these cells enter the alveolar lumen to clear up these debris, they get activated. they release more of inflammatory mediators. These inflammatory mediators or cytokines, they again act on the further alveolar epithelial cells. They damage. Once they're done with their function, these cells will undergo death. To clear off this, again, the macrophages will come. The macrophages will get activated with these inflammatory cytokines. Again, they produce more and more number of pro-inflammatory cytokines. This is the vicious circle. Hence, whenever there is a diffuse damage of the epithelial cells, you will have one, the process is chemotaxis. Chemotaxis. Inflammatory cells, they are present, are recruited into the alveolar lumen with damaged alveolar epithelial cells. Alveolar epithelial cell damage. So whenever you have, one thing you should remember, whenever there is an inflammation, along with the chemotaxis, other inflammatory cells, the adjacent structures, they also get damaged. So what will happen? There will be damage to the alveolar wall. At the same time, there is damage to the capillaries, interstitial capillaries. So here, the capillaries are very thin walled. They don't have any proper basement membrane. So once the capillaries are damaged, the plasma will also enter into the alveolar lumen. Okay? So, this is the initial phase. I repeat, I'll show you the picture. So, you can see this picture. When I have cells, ultimately when you see, you have a lot of or no damage, completely damaged alveolar epithelial cells. The plasma will be filled up in the alveolar lumen. All those nuclear and cytoplasmic debris of the fragmented and damaged cells will be entrapped in this fluid. You will see more of inflammatory cells, lymphocytes, neutrophils and macrophages. And you may see red blood cells also because of capillary damage. So this will impair the oxygen saturation or oxygen diffusion. Hence, any patient with acute respiratory distress syndrome, they how do they present? If this is diffuse involving most of the lung parenchyma, what can happen? These patients will have hypoxemia. Hypoxemia because impairment in the diffusion of the gases. So what are all the symptoms of hypoxemia? Tachycardia, tachypnea, low BP, all those things are the manifestations of hypoxemia. The patient will have anxiety episodes because the oxygen is not delivered to the structures and he will get anxiety. Then you will have mental confusion. Confusion, delirium mainly because of decreased oxygen supply to the brain. In severe cases, they may go for coma. Okay, and low BP. Low blood pressure. Finally, if it is not treated properly, the patient will land up in respiratory failure. Respiratory failure and patient may die because of this. Patient may die because of this. So, I repeat. So, in diffuse or in a classical case of acute respiratory distress syndrome, there will be impairment in the diffusion of gases leading to severe hypoxemia. The clinical signs and symptoms will be related to hypoxemia. And finally, when the hypoxia content is low, oxygen delivery is low to the organs, patient may present with multi-organ failure also. Multi-organ failure. So, because of these multiple symptoms, we call it as acute respiratory distress syndrome. These are the syndromic patient. But pathophysiology is always with diffuse damage of the alveolar. So that is diffuse alveolar damage. So these are the clinical features how the patient present with. One thing I would like to mention here is in this pathological process, always you should remember whenever if alveolar is any inflammation is there, there is always the equilibrium maintenance of pro-inflammatory and so pro-inflammatory cytokines and inhibitors. Here what happens, because of more of cellular recruitment chemostasis, the pro-inflammatory cytokines are markedly elevated with low inhibitor activity, finally leading to diffuse damage.
If any patient comes with a clinical
features of ARDS, if you advise chest X-ray, how does it look? Very important, all of you can see the chest X-ray of a patient of ARDS. What all can you observe? There is diffuse haziness, or you can say ground glass opacity of bilateral lungs. Bilateral diffuse opacification of the lung parenchyma. You can make out the diffuse. Mainly because due to infiltration of inflammatory cells in the alveolar interstitium. Heart shadow or heart will be normal heart shadow. There will be increased bronchovascular markings. Pulmonary edema will be very minimal. So this is acute phase. You may see or you may not see or minimal edema. Sorry, pleural effusion. Minimal pleural effusion. Okay, normal sized heart. So these are the important radiological features where it is helpful for the radiologist to say that it is acute lung injury or ARDS. So, if you examine microscopically, how does the ARDS look? There are three important stages they have mentioned. One, early stage, right? Early stage, we call it exudative phase. Exudative stage. Then you have proliferative stage. This is actually intermediate stage, and we have fibrotic stage. This is depending on the duration of the disease process. Early stage, what happened? This is the initial, when the patient present with immediate onset of respiratory symptoms. When you see this, you see a lot of pulmonary edema, hemorrhage, congestion of the blood vessels. Okay, when you see the gross morphology in this stage, all of you can make out the lungs, the bilateral lungs, all of you can see they become dusky, red in color, they're boggy, they're enlarged, filled with blood. So this is the classical gross pathology of exudative phase of or early stage of adult respiratory distress syndrome. Okay, this is a acute phase, lot of hemorrhage, blood will be collected, the lungs will become heavy, red in color, and this is how it looks. Can you see the cross pathology? Then what happens in proliferative stage? For example, I'll show you the picture also. If you see the microscopic picture of early stage, what happened? These are the alveoli. In the alveolar lumen, all of you can make out, there is an arrow mark there. The alveolar lumen is, inside is clear here. But if you see the wall is lined by a thin layer of eosinophilic material which is coating the alveolar lumen. If you observe carefully under high power microscope, you may see the nuclear debris present within this. Nuclear debris. These are the damaged inflammatory cells and alveolar epithelial cells. It forms. Why there is fibrous thickening here? When there is vascular damage, plasma protein will come into the, which starts accumulating in the alveolar lumen. Plasma protein threatens coagulation cascade. So when coagulation cascade is activated, ultimately what will happen? There is fibrin deposition. It forms the meshwork. Okay. The thick eosinophilic meshwork will be lining in the alveoli. It's just like a plastic cover, and it prevents the diffusion of gases. Okay, it prevents the diffusion of gases because it forms the thick layer. So, So, why it is important, why I am highlighting here is, I will tell you in the treatment aspect, right? Because this acute respiratory distress syndrome has got high mortality. Even if you give oxygen at this stage, it is very difficult that patient will get proper oxygen saturation. Why? Mainly because of thick eosinophilic membrane. It prevents the diffusion of gases in the alveolar capillary barrier. It's difficult to treat these patients. Okay. Lung, and you have a clear lumen and eosinophilic hyaline-like material. It looks like hyaline membrane disease of the newborn. So, this is the early exudative phase. When you see under microscopy, it looks like this. If you concentrate on septal capillaries will show marked congestion of the blood vessels. Okay, marked congestion and the hyaline membrane is the classical feature of early exudative phase of respiratory distress syndrome. What happens in proliferative stage? This gradually starts reabsorbing. So, all of you know, when in alveoli, you have two types of cells. Alveolar type 1, more sensitive for any kind of injury. Type 2 cells, they are little bit resistant to any kind of an injury. When there is damage, these cells will proliferate. These cells will start proliferating and forms the epithelial layer in the alveolar lumen. Later on, these cells will differentiate into type 1 alveolar epithelial cells. Later on, when it heals completely. But in the proliferative stage, there will be proliferation of these type 2 alveolar sites. When you see microscopically at this stage, you will see lung alveoli. You may see small part of hyaline membrane, but in rest of the area, you will see very prominent type 2 alveolar sites. We call it as hyperplasia of the type 2 pneumocytes. Hyperplasia of the type 2 pneumocytes. Hyperplasia. This is on the proliferative stage. What happens? If it is usually this ARDS patients very difficult. Very few patients will come back to normal. Majority of the patients, the complete normal recovery is not possible. So what happens ultimately? This also stimulates the interstitial fibroblastic cells. Interstitial fibroblastic cells. When you have more fibroblastic proliferation, the fibroblastic plugs will start accumulating in the interstitium. So interstitium will be this much thin. Now, because of fibroblastic proliferation, these are all fibroblasts. There will be widening of the interstitium. When there is fibrosis or widening, there is no diffusion of gases in the interstitium. You cannot do anything. Even if you give 100% oxygen, it will not be diffused properly. The patient will not get proper oxygenation. That you should remember. So, in fibrotic stage, or if you can see, there are a lot of fibroblastic plugs in the alveolar lumen. Occasionally, if you observe, you may see in some area the remnants of hyaline membrane disease. So, these three stages all of you should remember. Okay, these are the stages what I have mentioned. And this is about the acute respiratory distress syndrome. The last terminology all of you should know is acute interstitial pneumonia. One is acute, the same stage, acute because it is also acute interstitial pneumonia. Acute interstitial pneumonia. Acute interstitial pneumonia is nothing but acute respiratory distress syndrome. Clinically, all those patients will present like ARDS. Radiologically, all the radiological characteristics will be like ARDS. Histopathology, everything will be like ARDS. But what is here, we don't know the definitive etiological factors. When it becomes unknown, for ARDS, we had a long list of etiological factors, what causes ARDS. Even after excluding all the causes, if you don't know the causes, that is unknown, then we call it as acute interstitial pneumonia. Everything will be similar, but cause, what is causing, that we don't know. Okay, so this terminology we should impact. Lastly, the prognosis. prognosis. What happens to the patient if I develop a acute respiratory distress syndrome? If I am healthy, if I know the cause that something fracture is causing fat embolism leading to pulmonary ARDS or any kind of infection leading to ARDS, if I'm healthy, everything is fine, then my prognosis is comparatively good. Okay. If it includes multiple factors, the same patient is older age group and severe pulmonary damage, he is debilitating, then the prognosis is very bad. Ultimately, in general, any patient ARDS has bad prognosis. And why? The mortality rate will increase. So when you see, there is some studies, they quote, if you have ARDS, there will be 30 to 50% mortality per 100,000 population. Mortality rate is very high. Yeah? Because it is very difficult to treat. Right? Very few people, they recover. Very few will recover. Very few people, we don't know. If they are healthy, if it is minimal, mild severity, then those people will recover. But majority of the patients, they will die. So, what are the complications? What all can happen in acute lung injury? One, what all can happen? Because it is causing vascular damage, you can have multiple clots and embolism. Clot and embolism, embolic episodes can occur. This is one of the complications. If lung is severely involved, lung may collapse. Fibrotic lung, severe later stage, it can collapse. So, whenever there is airless lung or any damage, any foreign body, any foreign material, if it is accumulated in the alveolar lumen, more prone for recurrent infections. They are more prone for recurrent infections. Ultimately, end stage, later stage, if whole of the lung is involved, the fibrotic scar. Fibrotic scar is one of the most common complications. And finally, if the diffuse lung, bilateral lungs are involved, there is no oxygenation, oxygen hypoxemia, patient will have hypoxemia and they may have die because of multi-organ failure. One important thing that we should remember is these patients, even if you go oxygen therapy, it is very difficult to recover. So mainly because of thick hyalin membrane. Okay, this is important. So I repeat few important, the highlighting today's topic is, we spoke about acute lung injury. We have three main components, pulmonary edema, that we have dealt in detail. In today's class, we spoke about acute respiratory distress syndrome, its causes. When the disease or etiopathological factors are known, we call it as ARDS. ARDS, again, it is a clinical terminology. For pathologically, the only one mechanism, the one diagnosis is diffuse alveolar damage. And if you don't know the cause, rest of the clinical scenario or radiological scenario is same, then we call it as acute interstitial pneumonia. So, all of you should remember this. Thank you.